In this class, we are going to discuss about the protozoan diseases. We know diseases caused by several factors. Some diseases caused by bacteria, some diseases caused by virus, and some diseases caused by protozoans. You know protozoans, unicellular organism. These protozoans also cause diseases in human being. It's a real fact that in our body, in our human being body, so there are about 15 types of protozoans or leaves. It's a quite interesting fact. 15 types of protozoans or leaves inside the body, now also. But this causes some diseases. Out of this, one more important disease is caused by protozoa, that is called amoebiosis. It's called amoebiosis. So more than 15 types of genera, species, lives in our body. So out of this, the most important is, it's called amoebiosis. Amoebiosis, otherwise called amoebic dysentery or amoebic colitis or colitis, amoebic colitis. So these are the other names. This amoebiosis is a disease caused by a protozoan. The name is Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica. This is the species of the name of the protozoan which causes amoebiosis. One mark. So this amoebiosis especially lives in large intestine. This is also important. When infection takes place, after that what happens, this Entamoeba histolytica goes to large intestine where they live. This also one question, where they live? A large intestine or small intestine? In large intestine. So this amoebiosis caused by Entamoeba histolytica lives in large intestine. It feeds on mucus. We know mucus, the internal organs covered by a special substance is called mucus, which gives protection, which gives immune system to the organ. So all the internal organs covered by mucus, which gives protection. So that what happens, this Entamoeba histolytica feeds on that mucus and also bacteria. Some bacteria are there inside the body which is useful for us, which helps for us. So this Entamoeba histolytica feeds on two things. One is mucus and another one is bacteria which is present within the body which are useful for us. So after that what happens, this Entamoeba histolytica has a life history. It has several stages. It undergoes modifications inside the body. So out of this life history, one stage that is called trophozoite. Trophozoite is an important stage. This stage causes diseases. This is also one more question. Which stage of Entamoeba histolytica causes amoebiosis? The name is trophozoite. One more question. This is the infective stage. Which is infective stage of Entamoeba? Trophozoite is the infective stage of Entamoeba. What happens? This infective stage of Entamoeba is called trophozoite. Penetrates the large intestine. You know that large intestine like this. Just assume that this is a large intestine. This is the large intestine. Here small intestine is there. So here is joint. So large intestine. This is called colon region. Colon. This is transverse colon, ascending, descending colon. This is ascending colon. You know the structure. This transverse colon, descending colon, ascending colon. This is called sigmoid colon. So this Entamoeba lives in this region, in the colon region, especially in the large intestine. So Entamoeba, this Entamoeba lives in this region, especially in the colon region. Colon means it's a part of a large intestine. What happens? It penetrates the walls. It penetrates the walls. Here what happens? So that here mucus is present. This is mucus. So it eats on mucus, and also some bacteria which is present in the large intestine. So what happens if the mucus is removed? What happens here? Ulcer formation will take place. Here, ulcer formation takes place. So when the ulcer formation takes place, bleeding also occurs. Because of ulcer, because of bleeding, what happens? Abdominal pain may be there. These are the symptoms of this diseases. Okay, this penetrates the wall of intestine, especially the colon region. This is the colon region, large intestine. So it causes ulceration. The removal of mucus causes ulceration. This causes bleeding and also it causes abdominal pain. What happens? Actually, the stool, the fecus matter comes out along with blood and also mucus. So if you have blood on stool, that means maybe amebiasis. These are more important symptoms of amebiasis. What are the important symptoms? It leads to diarrhea and dysentery. It leads to from diarrhea to dysentery. What are the last takes place? Stool contains some blood drops and also mucus. So blood and the mucus in stool. This is the most significant symptoms of Entamoeba histolytica. So this Entamoeba histolytica is a disease which causes amebiasis, but through a vector unit will come inside the body. What is the vector? The vector is house fly. The name of the scientific, the house fly, the scientific name is Musca domestica. There may be question, they may ask this question. What is the scientific name of house fly? Musca domestica. This act as a vector. This house fly carries or transmits the Entamoeba histolytica to inside the body through contaminated water and food. Are you clear, students? Now we will see the diagram of Entamoeba histolytica. This is Entamoeba histolytica. This is inside, this is endoplasm. The outside is ectoplasm. This the membrane is called plasma membrane. So whereas inside the nucleus, one structure is called endosomes. This is the structure of a simple diagrammatic structure of Entamoeba histolytica. Thank you, students.